Hello, this is Kasim Kulov, and today I will show you how you can easily draw three types of infinity symbols in Illustrator. For this tutorial, we will be using a grid line every 128 pixels with four subdivisions. Enable grid and turn on the snap to grid option. I will not use fill and I will align stroke to center. Go to your ellipse tool and draw a circle holding down shift. Let's make a copy and put it right beside it. Select your scissors tool by clicking C and cut out the top right arc. Do the same with another circle and cut out the bottom left part. Let's make the stroke a little heavier, I will be using 64. Join these two, cut them out and join the others. Bring back the cut. Outline the stroke. Let's make a gap. Let's offset it by 16. So as to not get confused, let's give it a distinctive color. Click Shift-E to select your eraser tool and delete unnecessary parts of the offset. Apply the Pathfinder command to create the gap. Use Pathfinder again to unite all the shapes. And there you have it, this is your first basic infinity symbol. For the second type of infinity symbols, I will still use the same circles. But I will place them like so that their height and width are equal when they are selected. Draw a line from this point to this point and draw another perpendicular line. Let's give this stroke the same weight, 64. And this time I will use my ready-made actions to outline the stroke. And let's make a gap here too. Rotate the result 45 degrees and there you have it, this is your second infinity symbol. For the third type of infinity symbol, place two circles like so. Draw a tangent line like this and draw another line from the centers of the circles. Disable grid and snapping. Select all shapes, bring rotate tool by clicking R and rotate the shapes from the center of the first circle until you see that purple line. We don't need this line anymore. Select this line, copy it and paste in front and then flip it horizontally. Use Shape Builder tool to delete unnecessary lines. Apply the same weight to its stroke. Then outline the stroke. And let's add a gap. So yeah, this was it. Hope you liked this tutorial. For more interesting stuff, subscribe, I will not disappoint.